To help us make sense of today's market movements, we're now joined by Manny Ocampo of the Investment and Capital Corporation of the Philippines. Good afternoon, Manny, and welcome to Market Edge.
Hi, Stanley. Good afternoon.
Yes, taking a look, brief look at the figures now. We ended at 64.96. That's about 1.7% down from yesterday. 6,500 was breached. That's the main point of it. And this trading day saw losers also swamping gainers amid lackluster trading. Now, what happened there?
The interest rates will simply stated it's that, you know, U.S. Took a bit, dove, 760 points last night. So everybody except for Hong Kong followed suit. So I guess everybody, you know, people are just taking, markets are taking the cue from how U.S. Equity movements go. So that's par for the course, our side of town.
All right, we always thought that 6,500 was a good support, but it was breached today. And we have less than 10 days remaining of trading for the year. Now, weeks ago, it was an aspiration to have a 7,000 finish, but now it appears that even 6,800 is too high already. What 2022 ending level are you seeing, especially given today's pullback with no more interesting data to look forward to before we break for Christmas?
The bad news is out already. So if we stay within these levels, the 6,500, 6,600, I don't know, maybe a Santa Claus rally towards closer to maybe 6,700 is maybe possible. So we'll see. Like I said, the bad news is out. So, you know, consolidate from where we are at the current levels.
But the question really is there good news still in the next 2 weeks, though?
No, it's probably just a trading market, Stanley. You know, people will see where supports are and all. But, you know, you're right. People will probably start positioning maybe for the new year. There are sectors that continue to be interesting. As we've seen over, you know, we're starting to take a look at the year-to-date price charts. The banks, for example, have, you know, and even in a rising rate scenario, the banks have really, I guess, bucked the trend, if you like. And, you know, but that's there.
All right. Now, more than the interest rates, of course, the hikes yesterday, it's interesting to note that there's a bit of ambiguity in the messaging of our BSP governor, who said this may be the last in a considerable time that it is adjusting rates at least by 50 basis points. Right. On the one hand, though, it remains hawkish until next year. In the next couple of meetings, there will still be rate increases. How is the market sorting this out?
I think everybody expects rates to continue to go up. Until inflation comes down. You know, inflation has still been trending up over the past few months. We'd like to see a break in that trend, and maybe BSP will continue to adjust rates, albeit at lower percentages, 25 basis points. But until that happens, I guess 50 bips would still be the way BSP would be moving. I don't think they'll go 75 points. That is maybe out the equation right now. Thank you.
All right, Manny, now we're close to ending the year and looking back, which stocks would you consider as having performed well despite and against all odds, and which ones were dismal?
Okay, I'll make I'll do a top five.
Yeah, just a top five, perhaps.
Call on what maybe we call the dogs for at least a year to date. No? So big firms, you know, that may have been challenged one way or another for some reason or another. No? But just looking at price movements on a year to date basis. So you have Converge, AC Energy, Globe Telecom, Mondinisin, and Mega World. Now, that being said, I think, you know, if you were a one would have to take a look at have these fallen enough, and maybe are these maybe recovery
now,
stocks?
Right.
That's right. So, you know, one of those things. Sometimes it's easier to pick the next winners are those that have fallen quite a bit.
All right. Lastly, this year's daredevils, those that have debuted under really frightening market conditions,
right.
Manny. Considering 2023 would be a much better year, a lot of projections are saying that. Are you confident that investors would be more considerate with IPOs in the same way as companies would now be more daring in pursuing public fundraising activities?
Right. I think companies that pursue their IPOs have to have a, you know, a unique storyline that they bring. You know, are these are look at companies that will continue to progress despite market conditions. I think fundamentals will count you know very high as far as the picking order is concerned. No? Mm-hmm. So even in a rising interest rate scenario, will they perform well? Are they leveraged? No, things to look at. Will the IPO one? Pricing is another thing that we'd like to see issuers maybe take a second look at. I think investors now will want to come in and are still willing to come in, but they will have to take. You know, there has to be a compelling price story or upside over there.
All right. Thanks a lot for the insights. Again, as usual, thank you for being with us on the show, Mr. Manny Ocampo of Investment and Capital Corporation of the Philippines. Good afternoon to you.
Thank you, Stanley. Sorry. Merry Christmas also.
Merry Christmas.